Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and today I'm talking about the new Barb 4 PDO thread from NovaThread. So PDO threads have been around the world for many years. They've been in this country for a few years. They're all the rage now. There's several different companies selling threads, and you can get them overseas, you can get them within this country. And there are different threads in terms of smooth, barb, and twist. Where do we put them? Face, body, anywhere it's anatomically correct. But it also creates some confusion. Well, today I'm going through what's the barb thread. These are the ones with the cogs that create lifting. The barb thread does give that instant gratification that everyone loves. So the barb threads have evolved over time. And for me, the initial ones, how we place them, going in the skin and out the other side, the tensile strength that created some irregularities in the skin and some side effects are being slowly worked out like every other treatment. And I'm really excited about the new Barb 4. It has a full cannula on it. So it's a full length cannula, blunt tipped, and the exit point is distal, more proximal from the tip. So it's separate. It's not a half cannula like some of the threads. We used to put the bevel down so the thread was a little deeper. And remember, you can watch the videos of these being done, but the depth is one of the most important things. Figuring out the vector, and it's different for many people depending on your consult, but the depth of the thread. But putting the cannula tip on an upward trajectory is what really helps get that correct plane, not too deep and not too superficial. I think the tensile strength of the thread really plays a role, and that's developed over time so that you don't get the puckering or some of those side effects. I find that it's a very smooth application, and most of all, for some reason, it's a lot more comfortable for the patients, because doing facial threads, there's two areas that are somewhat tender that we all kind of shudder a little bit as the cannula gets down there and see, how's our patient gonna react? Are they gonna be stoic and have no pain? Or sometimes the pain can be difficult to overcome. And those areas are the nasolabial fold and the melomental fold down by the edge of the mouth. And trying to use sometimes nitrous helps a little bit. Numbing it with a nerve block helps a little bit, but not totally. I think the number one way is adding a bit of lidocaine, coming down that track, and then maybe 0.5 cc's, not a lot, and then employing the thread. Not too much water because the thread will not grab. So used in that way, if you need to use lidocaine or numbing at all, some people do fine without it. So the Barb 4 thread, it's totally blunt, it's smooth, there seems to be less pain in the application, and just the evolving techniques of how we do them, how we use them, get the patient to animate before cutting the edge, has really helped get great results, provide lift, and the instant result that Americans love. Thanks for joining me today. Join us on this YouTube channel. Love to hear your comments below on the threads you use, your experience with threads, whether you're a patient or an injector. Also follow us on Instagram and Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, vibrant.